This video I'm going to describe reaction rates and production rates when we have multiple reactions. And the idea here is we want to demonstrate how to use a stoichiometry matrix to relate the reaction rates, namely the rate of one reaction. In this case, for the example here, three reaction, R1 would be the reaction rate. To production rates. Production rates, for example, would be the rate that C forms, or if it's negative, it's decomposing, but the rate that C or the rate that D forms. And so we have five rates of formation of individual reactants, and we have three reaction rates. And then the second objective is, using again matrix calculations, calculate the rates of reaction, calculate R1, R2, and R3 if we have measurements of the rates of A, B, C, D, and H, using a least squares approach to account for the fact that these measurements are going to have errors, and so the stoichiometry is not going to be perfectly satisfied because of that. So we can write the rate that species A forms, and it's minus R1, minus sign because it's reactant. The rate of B, well, B is involved in two reactions, R1 minus R2, and likewise, C is involved in two reactions, R2 minus R3. D is only involved in one reaction, and then H is involved in all three reactions as a reactant, so its stoichiometric coefficient is negative in each case. So we're also going to define first the matrix. Call this A, and I'll use this video the black, more intense symbols to represent a matrix, and then this matrix is to just represent the species that are involved in the reaction. So a 5x1 matrix. And then we want to also define a second matrix, that matrix nu, where nu times A is going to be equal to 0. This represents the reactions that we've written, and the easiest way is to write down what nu is to make it clear what we're referring to. So nu is a matrix. So this first line represents the first reaction up here, where what I'm going to represent, this is A, B, C, D, and H. So A has a stoichiometric coefficient minus 1. B has a stoichiometric coefficient plus 1. C and D are not involved in reaction. H also has a stoichiometric coefficient of minus 1. Using that same idea, I can write down for the second reaction, and then for the third reaction, the stoichiometric coefficients. And so this matrix nu times the matrix A equal to 0, which is equivalent to writing these reactions with everything on the right side, minus A, minus H, plus B equals 0. So reactants have stoichiometric coefficients of minus 1. Products have stoichiometric coefficients of plus 1. In this case, there's no 2 or 3 stoichiometric coefficients. If we want to know what these production rates are, we can define a matrix R for the production rates. And this is just these five rates that I've written the equation for. That's the matrix for the production rates. That's going to be equal to a matrix that's the transpose of V times a matrix that is the rates of R1, R2, and R3. So I've written now the rates of production in terms of the transpose R1, and so we can write this as then that matrix for the rates of production, stoichiometric coefficient transpose, and matrix R for the individual reaction rates. This matrix arises, let's look at the rate of C. So it's 0 times R1, 1 times R2, minus 1 times R3. And indeed, that's the rate that we wrote up here for RC. And we can do the equivalence for the other. Then what we'd like to use this for is if we measure these values and want to determine these values. So we measure RA, RB, RC, RD, and RH. some conditions, we want to know the corresponding values for R1, R2, and 3. And of course, these measurements have some errors in them, and we means they won't satisfy the stoichiometry perfectly because of the errors, so we want to do a least squares fit to get the best value. So in the next screencast, we'll go through the calculations of how to use this matrix notation to do this least squares fit, get the best answers for measurements that have errors, which of course all measurements do.